Hello friends, let's talk about another concept in 1D array, search for an element in an array, and we are going to implement linear search. Now let's see how it works. Consider we have an array A, let's say of size n equals to 5, and let the array element be 10, 5, 20, 6, 17, sequence of the element is immaterial. And let's say suppose I want to search for an element 6 in my array. Now this linear search working is like this. You're going to start from the first position and then you're going to compare value x with each of the array element. And the moment you found the element, you're going to stop the search. See, we are not going to count the frequency or the number of occurrence. So if you say agar 6 yahan pe, 2 pe mil gaya, then what we should do, we should stop. We should not go to search ki bhai 3 pe bhi hai ki nahi, because not this is not the our intention at this point of time. By intentions, whether this element 6 belong or is contained in this array or not. So how it's going to work? First I will be 0, we will check if x is equals to a of 0, no, then I become 1. If x equals to a of 1, no, then I is 2. If x equals to a of 2, no, I is 3. If x equals to a of 3, yes. At third position, it is equal. At position 0, 1, 2, they are not found to be equal. And the moment x become equal to a of 3, will break. So what was the value of I when this was terminated? It was 3, means it was still less than n. Now why I'm saying n? Because n is 5. So the last index position where my element is probably there will be at position n minus 1. So from index position 0 to n minus 1, there is a chance my element can be present, if at all, at any position. Now suppose I'm looking for an element 25. I want to find whether 25 is present in this array or not. And obviously we can see it is not there. But how my machine will understand? Let us see it. Initially I is 0, is x equals to a of 0, no. Then I is 1, is x equals to a of 1, no. I is 2, is x equals to a of 2, no. I is 3. Is x equals to a of 3, no. I is 4. Is x equals to a of 4, no. I become 5. Now just concentrate on value of I. Value of I becomes greater than n minus 1. Means if value of I eventually becomes equals to n, then the element is not there. Then element nahi hai. Because agar एलिमेंट एरे में होगा तो 0 से n माइनस 1 पोजीशन पे ही होगा, दिस इज फॉर श्योर. सो हमारा टर्मिनेटिंग कंडीशन क्या है कि फॉर लूप के बाद जब हम आइटरेट करेंगे, सी कैसा होगा, इट विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस. विल राइट फॉर i इक्वल्स टू 0, सॉरी i इक्वल्स टू 0, i लेस देन n, i प्लस प्लस. If x becomes equals to the ith element of the array, you will simply break. Khatam. This is the for loop. Now, agar aap dekhe, loop terminate hone ke do baatein ho sakti hai. Ya to agar element mil gaya, to break ki wajah se terminate hoga. Agar element hai hi nahi, to I less than n, ye condition false ho jayega. Now, agar aap ye dekhe, when I am talking about x equal to 6, at I equal to 3, x will become equals to a of 3, so break will execute. So after this for loop, what is value of I? 3. Now if when I was looking to search for 25, we found that from 0 to 4, from I position 0 to 4, x is not equal to a of I, so I eventually becomes 5. So 5 less than 5, no. It means that after this loop, we should check value of I. If I becomes equal to n, it means that from position 0 to n minus 1, my element is not present. सो आफ्टर दिस फॉर लूप इफ आई इवेंचुअली बिकम इक्वल टू एन, यू विल से एलिमेंट नहीं है, इट्स नॉट प्रेजेंट इन द एरे, बट अगर वो एन नहीं है तो जीरो से लेके एन माइनस वन तक कोई भी वैल्यू हो सकता है, वी विल से एलिमेंट इज प्रेजेंट इन द एरे. सो दिस इज द लॉजिक फॉर सर्चिंग ऑफ एलिमेंट इन एन एरे. दिस इज नोन एज लीनियर सर्च.